AVZ Minerals over this past week released a significant announcement that they've officially secured their $240 million worth of funding from CATH. Along with the funding which de-risks the project, it also points to some potentially favourable conditions for some of those last things that AVZ Minerals are waiting to tick off, including the mining licence and the collaboration agreement. Of course, once AVZ Minerals have secured these, they'll then look forward to a final investment decision and being able to develop and move towards construction and production of the Manono Lithium and Tin Project. Manono, of course, is one of the world's largest undeveloped lithium resources. It is a massive resource, and it's very high grade as well. So investors are looking forward to this opportunity eagerly as AVZ Minerals await this mining license. Today, we're going to unpack what this recent announcement means, but we'll also talk about the pathway up ahead for AVZ. There's a few different catalysts, a few things to look forward to, and we'll break all of these down. Before, of course, we unpack these near-term catalysts, it probably makes sense for us to think about the CATH agreement that was recently locked in. So just as a bit of a reminder, as we can see here, CATH will earn a 24% equity interest in the venture for the Manono Lithium and Tin Project. CATH will pay US$240 million of cash for a 24% equity interest. As a result of that, AVZ Minerals still retains 51% majority ownership, and the balance is currently owned by the DRC government. The transaction in totality is estimated to be worth more than US$400 million, and this will come as a result of CATH also having to fund their pro-rated portion of the Manono project. Of course, funding at such a significant scale, as well as a partner like CATH, who is part-owned by leading global lithium-ion battery manufacturer CATL, has brought a lot of attention and eyes onto ASX AVZ. And so with that understanding and context, we can then think about why this recent announcement for AVZ Minerals attracted so much ASX investor interest and why ASX AVZ share price rose by over 15% on the news. As we know, there was a couple of condition precedents that were needing to be secured before the funding was ultimately unlocked. What was major about this announcement was the funding was secured, but AVZ and CATH, through their discussions, have agreed to waive the following conditions precedent. One was the mining license being granted, two was the collaboration agreement being secured, and three was that a final investment decision was agreed upon. Each of these were some uncertainties that investors have been waiting to see would finally come through. Of course, the AVZ team are very excited and very positively thinking about each of these, and they're hoping that the mining license will be granted in the near future. But the fact that these condition precedents were agreed to be waived speaks to the opportunity and the confidence that both AVZ and CATH have surrounding all three of these different factors. Investors are now eagerly awaiting any upcoming news, but it does look like there's a lot of opportunities. And of course, a leading company like CATH would not part ways with their money. They would be doing a lot of their due diligence. They obviously have a lot of bullish support and excitement surrounding what lays around the corner. And so then I think just having a bit of a think about some of the key enablers that will help to develop AVZ's Manono project. As we mentioned at the top of the video, Manono is the world's largest undeveloped lithium project. It is a massive resource. It's currently got 400 million tons already JORC compliant at a very high grade, above 1.6%. But the team at AVZ have already previously stated that they believe this is only the tip of the iceberg, and there truly is further opportunities and upside. They continue to drill this out, but it does speak to a good runway up ahead for years to come. If you are interested in more insights about the AVZ story, we've previously interviewed Nigel Ferguson, the CEO of ASX AVZ, so we'll leave links to that interview at the end of this one that you can check out. But there are a few other enablers that are really going to help to facilitate the success of Manono Lithium's project if it can come online. Firstly, of course, is government support. Not only for the mining license, which is critical, but there's a range of different negotiations as well that will play out, such as a hybrid tax regime and the opportunity to really feed into the DRC's EV battery mineral supply chain. This, of course, is going to continue to be built out, and AVZ are hoping that they can be a key leader in the space. Along with that as well, currently the DRC government owns 25% of the project. They need to own 10% as a result of the mining code, but it'll be interesting to see where that dynamic lands and how much of the project they do end up owning. On the infrastructure side, of course, we'll talk about this later in the video as well, but the Manono project, of course, will need good quality transport and logistics surrounding it. But also on the energy side, they are getting the renewable hydroelectric plant up and running. This is going to help them to produce sustainable and low carbon emissions lithium, and it's of course going to be more and more important as they look for further offtakes and discussions with companies who want to bring down the embodied energy on that manufacturing side. Of course, the CATH partnership and funding is a significant de-risker, and it's also a major enabler of bringing the project online. And I think what's exciting about the AVZ story is the opportunity for further expansion and scalability, which we'll talk about later on. Not only do they have a massive resource already in terms of current scale, but there is further upside to go, as well as opportunities to look further downstream too. If you do enjoy this video, don't forget to hit the like button, feel free to share it out, and make sure you've subscribed and turn your bell notifications on as well, so you won't miss any of our daily episodes. And so then I guess building on the downstream opportunities discussion. As we know, lithium developers and producers globally are all trying to continue to pursue downstream opportunities. Obviously, there's a significant focus on localization of supply chains. Capturing more of the value chain is better for profitability, and it gives you more exposure to the larger margins as well, the further downstream that you can go. But for AVZ specifically, there are a range of different opportunities as well that they can unlock by bringing on the potential to look further downstream and ultimately potentially a lithium hydroxide facility, and potentially even further than that as well, getting closer towards the battery side. In terms of the downstream opportunities that a lithium hydroxide plant would facilitate, I think first and foremost, it's worth noting AVZ's location. The DRC sits relatively in the middle of Africa in terms of its physical location. As a result of that, obviously, you want to be transporting less of the product out to the ports and being able to ship it out. This is better for the environment, obviously having to transport less. But also, if you can bring down your unit costs as well on the logistics side, it means that you're ultimately going to enable yourself to have better margins. So downstream helps to reduce those costs. It improves additional environmental benefits. And it also is a good negotiating point as well in discussions with potential off-takers and manufacturers. So as we can see here, at the moment for AVZ's operations, they've got the SC6 production that they're looking to move towards, and primary lithium sulfide production and processing. But then they want to look further downstream in terms of lithium hydroxide. And then there's question marks. Is there the opportunity for cathode and anode production? Obviously cell production, battery assembly. And then the factor that they've already got this discussions and this partnership with CATH, who's part owned by CATL, it obviously gives them a lot of insights and feeds them into a supply chain already, which they'll be able to continue to provide SC6 into moving forward for years to come. And so then I think just thinking about the pathway forward for ASX AVZ. Firstly, I'm very keen to hear your thoughts on it all. So drop in a comment below what you think about AVZ Minerals, what you thought about the recent announcement, and also where do you think the broader lithium sector heads from here moving forward. It's worth noting as well that I'm not a financial advisor. Obviously, I'm just a bloke on the internet who likes talking about stocks. So nothing we discuss is a buy recommendation or financial advice. Hopefully it's an interesting starting spot, however, for you to go away and do your own research from. So AVZ will move towards a final investment decision following expansion studies, the confirmation of the mining license, and a BFS will flow out of that on the back of their DFS that they've already completed. There's interesting excitement surrounding the expansion study opportunity. Current throughput is for 4.5 million tonnes per annum, but they're exploring the opportunity to uplift that to 10 million tonnes per annum, and this came off the back of the CATH agreement. Further drilling as well, as we mentioned, the current JORC resource is already 400 million tonnes, which is absolutely massive, and this is at above 1.6% grade, so it's high grade too. But the AVZ team have previously stated that there's a potential exploration target of over a billion tonnes, potentially up to 1.5 billion tonnes, and they envisage that it could be high grade and continue that high grade as well, maybe up to that 1.5% mark. So obviously further drilling will extend the life of mine and the throughput that they're able to provide onto stakeholders and customers moving forward. Then that government deal front is going to be important too. As mentioned, currently the DRC government owns 25% of the project. By the mining code law, they must own 10%, but there will be negotiations and discussions to see how much of the project they do end up owning, and the dynamics of how that play out will be obviously important moving forward. And then the production beginning. So the pathway that AVZ have outlined is hopefully shovels in the ground this year, construction in 2022, and then ultimately moving towards SC6 production in 2023. We've talked about it a lot on the channel previously, obviously with the elevated lithium prices, which do continue going higher and higher at this stage, the nearer term producers and current producers give themselves the best exposure to those elevated prices that they're able to feed into and sell into. So AVZ is a relative near term producer if they can come online into 2023, and that's why they're attracting a lot of attention. As mentioned, we've previously interviewed Nigel Ferguson as well as other ASX Lithium CEOs on the channel. We'll leave links to those up above. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for joining us. For now, stay well and happy investing.